He's done loads and loads of stand-up for Labour shows. He's also appeared in Red Dwarf. Have you seen Red Dwarf? And he's a very funny man. So here he is, Norman Lovett. I've got proper pictures, Crispy. There's a picture you took, wasn't it? I've got proper professional pictures of me that are better than that. It hurts. I mean, when I first started, I was so good looking, it was all hard for me to do comedy at all because there'd be women and men sort of in awe. Yeah, just in awe of sort of like, oh, you know, I could hear, I could feel it, and that was tough. And yeah, but now I'm 71 now, so I've got to, that's helped in a way. So, and oh, that was loud, wasn't it? Just too loud. I'm just thinking, I'm not looking at my watch. Well, I am. It's a good idea to look at your watch at the beginning because you've got 20 minutes and it's just coming up to 20 to 10. It'll fly by. Timberland watch, 100 quid, as opposed to Michael McIntyre's watch, which he lost. Got robbed, didn't he?
Yeah.
I mean, if I had that load of money, I wouldn't buy one of those Rolex things. I mean, he's probably got about 10 on his bedroom floor. You know, well, where did that one today? What is it? I paid, is it worth a point? You know, I don't know. Oh, stupid. And this is Timberland as well. Yeah, I started off with the main reason I went into rucksack, the world of rucksack. I'd had one before, and then I had a normal one. This is, I call this super. So, you know, it doesn't cost tuppence, put it that way. I'll buy twice, you know, buy cheap, buy twice.
Yes.
It's quite true, isn't it? Buy cheap, buy twice. Quite a good bit of advice. It's nice here, isn't it? I thought very. Very bloody conservative, eh? Yeah, you can feel it, can't you? Yeah, you're surprised you're here. We hope we could have more in the audience, but there's about 40 odd of you, so it's better that we kick up the arse, isn't it? That's something I'm working on. Oh my god. What time do we start? 22, wasn't it? Yeah, 5, 10, 15, just coming up to 20 minutes. That's what I'm supposed to finish at 20 minutes, and I've still got a lot to do. So, it's gone so quickly. I said it would go quickly. I said, I should take it to I'll go past the 10 o'clock, you know, I'll push it over. I know they want to stop at 10 because, but they can't. Right? Lights are very good, Crispin. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Yeah. I couldn't see you because I was blinded by them. No, they're really good. Smashing. We've had a lot of lighting problems around the country with all the gigs we do. We've been to Blackpool, Manchester, Chorley?
Yay!
Southport.
Clapton? No, we haven't been there. I went to school at Clapton. I went to a Clapton Secondary Modern School, and I left that school with one O level, but they caught up with me and made me bring it back. But I actually have got one O level. It's in technical drawing, and it was a reset. And it was just me resitting it at Christmas, and the teacher was standing there, and we had about 10 minutes to go, and you could see I was stumped. I couldn't. And he came across, and he helped me. That's the only reason I passed. he'll be dead. He'll be dead now. And that O-level has never helped me at all. No one's ever said, you've got an O-level technical drawing. You're hired. It's never helped me, so it's not so bad. Yeah, death. Yeah, but once I had a dream about death. I was sitting in bed. The dream was about me being in bed, sitting up reading, and the door came in, and this sort of hooded person with a scythe came in, and he said, "I said, who are you?" And he said, "I'm the Gay Reaper." And I said to him, "I said, it's grim, isn't it?" And he said, "I like it." And I said, "I don't want to die. I don't want to die." And he said, "Shove over. We'll talk about it." Bit gay. I've mentioned gay too many times tonight. I'm feeling. I've been attacked for that in some quarters. That's funny though, isn't it? It's quite funny that I'm a gay reaper and it's supposed to be grim and it hurts. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, that's it. That's my coffee thing. I get this and they fill it up in the shop. You know, Starbucks. Nero's is my coffee place of choice. Nero's. Nero's? Yeah. We saw a big Starbucks on the way, didn't we? No, but it was like a pub. Yeah, big Starbucks, you know what I mean? Yeah. I thought, look, they're turning into sort of pubs now. And big, I'm bigger and bigger, yeah. What did you... What, that was such a tiny voice, it could have been a little ant.
They said they were going to pay their taxes.
I can't understand the accent. It probably means I've got to go and get my bloody ears tested, one of these. Say it again.
I said Starbucks don't pay their taxes.
Yeah, I know. nor do I, mate. I bloody do. Not Jimmy Carr, am I? I like Jimmy Carr. I've met him a few times and I do like him. I think he's a good person. And he's just unfortunate about that, really. The accountant might have said, look, we can get this down if we do this. I don't know. I don't know what happened. Ken Dodd kept a load of dough under his bed, didn't he? Do you remember that? He kept a load of dough. I think everyone fiddles a bit. Cash in hand, there's a lot of that going on. Yeah. I'm not getting cash for this. I'm getting virtually nothing for this. Now, who else fiddles? Boots do as well, don't they?
Yeah.
Richard Branson?
Yeah. And Nero.
And Nero as well?
Yeah.
Oh. What about McDonald's? Never heard anything about. All you hear about is they had a problem selling chicken, which isn't chicken,
yeah.
Which they did an advert about. Didn't they? An advert to say, this is real chicken, isn't it? You know, to make it. I hate McDonald's. I was offered a voiceover for McDonald's and I refused to do it because I thought I'd be such a hypocrite if I did this. I'd be treading along the line of Carol Vorderman doing that advert for lending money, which she did for years and years, and she's incredibly rich. Yeah. How can she sleep at night? But she does. I'm sure she does. No, I can't stand her for that. And you see that they wanted to get Carol Vorderman because good at maths. But not as good as Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley's sharper than her, much quicker than her. And every time Jimmy Carr does a joke about Carol Vorderman, they put the camera on Rachel Riley, doesn't she? And she just does a try not to laugh too much. That's funny. I better get off. I might leave the sugar babes out tonight. I'm finishing up now because Crispy. I've been calling him Tarquin. I called him Tarpy by mistake, and he didn't like that at all. I said, well, it's just like someone calling me Gordon instead of Norman. That isn't it, that sort of area. You know, Gordon, you know. This is, I get a laugh doing that. It's like Jimmy Carr when he started doing that laugh. I don't like that laugh. But he's not going to give up with it, is he? That's going on, that's staying. I record as, have you noticed what programme is on at the moment while the World Cup is on? The One Show. It's frightening, isn't it? I've got a bit of it here. This is an opening. When we had that really snowy weather, and they did a little intro with a pair of them, Alex Jones and the other bloke. I don't know, I've forgot his name. Music. It's not like the Sugar Babes. I'm going to finish with this. I'm a big fan of the Sugar Babes, and then it all went wrong. I'll condense this. I usually do talk about them, not at length, but quite a bit. So I'm a bit of a fan of the songs, but the original Sugar Babes, they all left in the end, didn't they? The fake Sugar Babes, I called them. And Mucha is the one who's got the really deep. Alright, steady on. Mucha had the real deep, she was the glue of the Sugar Babes. But when you look at her, you're scared stiff of her, she's frightening. And they just stand there in their microphones, the fans all came and they just did the songs, no dance routines. And they were happy, they enjoyed the songs, but they didn't move, they just come out, do the stuff. And then they left, the originals left, and they got the record company going, oh, we can't, you know, we can carry on with the Sugar Babes, even though they're not real sugar. You don't, you're off then? Huh?
Wait a minute, yeah.
It's nice to get my, catch my attention with that, just to let you know. I couldn't even wait, I think this is the last thing, you know. So I'll put my coat on this and rush him up. Rush him off the bloody stage. I don't know what the tactic is. But it is cold out there, quite it's a bit colder now. I'm doing a bit of weather forecasting now. Your light's flashing there, flash there, did you see that? It did a flash just then. Is that 10 o'clock? We've got to be home by 10 or no? Doesn't matter. Are we quite near the sea here? No. I was saying it's to do with the sea that it's colder here, but it's not at all, really. It's quite warm. Huh? The Tories, cold Tories. You said it. Privileged shits. No, I can't. I must never. You must never generalise. If someone's a Tory, it doesn't make them a bad person. There are nice Tories as well. They do exist. Well, they do exist, really. I mean, even in that group of people, and businessmen as well, you know, like Trump's first businessman to go into business, into politics. What am I talking about at the time? It's time for your bloody tablets and all. Trump, you know, and Farage, businessman, kicked off the UKIP thing, didn't he? Because people don't go into politics that come from business, because they go into business because of money. They get more money there, so that's changing a bit. Look what it's done. The Sugar Babes, yeah, they were great. This is a song I particularly like of theirs, and now, one of the girls singing on this is a fake Sugar Babe. But she replaced one of the girls that left very early on in the first year of their performing career. Heidi Range, her name is, she came in and left, and after the Irish one, Siobhan, left after being, you know, getting a plane home from Australia to her mother and complaining of being bullied by Keisha, the tall black sugar babe. But he never went to court or anything, but so they got Heidi Range, who came from the Liverpool, and she came from the Atomic Kitten camp. I don't know if you knew that. Yeah, she was in the camp. She wasn't an atomic kitten, but she could have been. You know, that was a she was in the squad, if you like. So here it is. Here's the sugar babes.
You look into my eyes, I go round on my mind. I can't see anything, cause this love's got me blind. I can't help myself, I can't break the spell, I can't even try.
Here comes Heidi.
I'm in over my head, you got under my skin. I got no strength at all in the state that I'm in. My knees are weak and my mouth can't speak. Fell too far this time.
Oh God, I haven't stopped it now. Yeah, there we go.
Right, okay. never really had a chance to,
you know, cover the whole area. There's not enough time in the world. You have to do what you can. And I feel I've done that tonight. So thanks very much for coming. Thank you very much.
Okay, so I know that you're all very excited about the raffle, is that right?
Yeah.
Have you all got tickets?
Yes.
It's not. Is it too late to buy a ticket for anyone?
Who wants a ticket?
Anyone want to buy tickets?
No.
They're off. Right, okay. Right, so yeah, we've got all the prizes are over there. Where's the... Jessica, thank you, Jessica, for organising the raffle. And wow, look at all these tickets. Wow, there must be at least 20 in here. Wow, this is a big raffle here. I reckon we've got quite a few winners here tonight. Here. Wow.